Hello, I'm Professor Von Schmohawk, and welcome to YU. In the first lecture, we explored the origins of the first number systems. We also saw how the people on my primitive island of Coco Loco first learned about the decimal number system. Once the Coco Loconians discovered decimal numbers, we could do much more than count coconuts. We could do arithmetic calculations with coconuts. The first arithmetic operations we invented were addition and subtraction, which came in very handy when dealing with coconuts. For instance, if you have 3 coconuts, and then your neighbor gives you 5 more, you will have 8 coconuts. Interestingly, if you start out with 5 coconuts, and then your neighbor gives you 3 more, you will also have 8 coconuts. For some reason, 5 plus 3 gives you the same answer as 3 plus 5. Eventually, we figured out that it doesn't matter in which order you acquire your coconuts, you still end up with the same number of coconuts. Since the 2 numbers on either side of the addition symbol can switch positions without changing the answer, we say that they commute, since commute means to travel back and forth. Mathematical operations in which the numbers operated on can be switched without affecting the result are said to be commutative. This illustrates what the Coco Loconians call the commutative property of addition of coconuts. Apparently, this property applies to adding anything, so we will just call it the commutative property of addition. So addition is a commutative operation. Instead of talking about specific numbers like 3 and 5, if we call these 2 quantities A and B, then we can write this property in a more general way. Although addition is a commutative operation, subtraction is not. For example, 4 minus 3 is 1. However, if you switch the order of the 3 and the 4, the result will not be the same. 3 minus 4 is negative 1. As we saw in the previous lecture, we can write 4 minus 3 as an addition of positive 4 plus negative 3. Now, since addition is commutative, we can switch the 4 and the negative 3 without changing the result. This is a trick which can come in handy in algebra problems. Addition is a binary operation. Binary operations are mathematical calculations which involve 2 numbers. These numbers are called operands, and in the case of addition, these operands are added together to produce a result called the sum. In addition operations, the operands are sometimes referred to as the addends. Even though addition is defined as a binary operation, you may often see additions involving more than 2 operands. This is possible because pairs of operands can be added one at a time, with each sum replacing the pair. In this way, an unlimited number of operands can be added sequentially. The commutative property can be applied to addition operations involving more than 2 numbers. By switching adjacent pairs of numbers, operands can be reordered in any way we please. For instance, in this addition involving 4 operands, the 2 at the end could be moved up to the front. Or the 5 could be moved to the back. In addition to the commutative property, here is another interesting property of addition that we discovered. Let's say that you have 5 coconuts, and your neighbor on the left has 3. Both of you get together and pool your coconuts into one group of 8. Then, your neighbor on the right gives you 4 more. Now you will have your group of 8 plus 4 more for a total of 12 coconuts. On the other hand, let's say you started out by pooling your 5 coconuts with your neighbor on the right who had 4 coconuts. So you start out with a group of 9 coconuts. Then your neighbor on the left gives you his 3, so you end up with 3 plus your group of 9, or a total of 12 coconuts. You still end up with the same number of coconuts. In these two scenarios, the coconuts were grouped in different ways before they were added. However, we ended up with the same number. This illustrates what is called the associative property of addition, because it doesn't matter in which way the coconuts are grouped or associated with each other before they are added. In the end, they all add up to the same number. If we call these quantities A, B, and C, then we can write this property in a more general way. The commutative property of addition involves moving around the numbers to be added, whereas the associative property of addition involves grouping them differently. Using both the associative and commutative properties, we can rearrange groups of numbers. Let's see what this looks like on a number line. As an example, we will take an addition problem involving positive and negative numbers. Let's start at the origin and add positive 2. Plus positive 3, plus negative 6, plus negative 2, plus positive 4. This all totals up to 1. However, because of the commutative property, we are free to rearrange the sequence of numbers in any order we like. For instance, we could add all the negative numbers first, and we still get the same result. We could also use the associative property to group some of the numbers to be added. For instance, the negative 2 and the positive 2 could be grouped. Since this group adds up to 0, we could replace it with a 0, or eliminate it altogether. Having a familiarity with the properties of addition allows us to start building a tool chest of mathematical tricks which we can use later to simplify complicated problems. In the next few lectures, we will explore the properties of more arithmetic operations such as multiplication and division.